Hi, good day, everybody. So my name is Dr. Yudi Fernando. I'm currently working with a graduate school of business in the Science Relation. And my research area about service management, service marketing, and some kind of operations and management. So today, I'd like to talk about a few chapter in your paper that we know and understand our subject is 062AG, Service Marketing and Retails. Alright, I will cover chapter 3 and 4 for this moment. So we talk about the promoting and positioning as it is a part of our session 3. Okay, when we talk about a service contributions to the country that currently all people around the world aware that service industry can contribute to economic growth. But when we look at from the past, UK GDP gross domestic product actually had contributed to UK economy where more than 50% of GDP that been contributed by service industry. Yes, you are right. Currently, a lot of service company or service industry or service areas of the service business in the market. For example, banking, insurance, and many more, right? Okay, but not all of us produce a service itself. Some of us produce a product to be sold to the customer. But nowadays, to sell a product itself to the customer without any specific information and consultations, that your product very difficult for the customer to consider and to buy to the end. Alright, perhaps your product needs to be provided by some information and consultations to represent an important way to add a value to the product. So not many of our customers have a similar knowledge. Not all our customers understand how to fully utilize our product. Prospective customers might need information and advice about what the service options are available to them. Where and when the services are available, how much they cost, and what specific feature, functions, and service benefits there are. So our customer needs some kind of advice where and when they need to consume the service. For example, when you want to get or you want to buy the insurance policy, perhaps you need to get an advice from somebody else in the insurance industry, which policy or which policy you need to buy, right? For example, there is an option A, B, C, and D. For example, the life insurance, like your asset insurance, many more. You need to get some information from the specialist in insurance industry, and you might need to know how much will it cost you and what the features and can benefit you as a customer itself. And nowadays, the company and the customer itself build a very close relationship and they communicate each other, perhaps with two-way communications. Communication at part serves to maintain the contact with an organization's existing customers and build a relationship with them. So it's not only you sell at one time, you might need a repeat purchase to your product or services. Alright, why do the marketing communication is... Hi, good day everybody. So my name is Dr. Yudi Fernando, currently working with a graduate school of business in the science relation. And my research area about service management, service marketing, and some kind of operations and management. So today I'd like to talk about a few chapter in your paper that we know and understand. Our subject is 0628G, service marketing and retails. Alright, I will cover chapter 3 and 4 for this moment. So we talk about the promoting and positioning as it is a part of our session 3. Okay, when we talk about service contributions to the country that currently all people around the world aware that service industry can contribute to economic growth. But when we look at from the past, UK GDP, gross domestic product, actually had contributed to UK economy where more than 50% of GDP that been contributed by service industry. Yes, you are right. Currently, a lot of service economy or service industry or service areas of the service business in the market. For example, banking, insurance, and many more, right? Okay, but not all of us produce a service itself. Some of us produce a product to be sold to the customer. But nowadays, to sell a product itself to the customer without any expensive information and consultations, that your product is very difficult for the customer to consider and to buy to the end. Alright, perhaps your product needs to be provided by some information and consultations to represent an important way to add value to the product. So not many of our customers have a similar knowledge. Not all our customers understand how to fully utilize our product. Prospective customers might need information and advice about what the service options are available to them, where and when the services are available, how much they cost, and what specific feature, functions, and service benefits there are. So our customer need some kind of advice where and when they need to consume the service. For example, when you want to buy the insurance policy, perhaps you need to get an advice from somebody else in the insurance industry, which policy or which policy you need to buy, right? For example, there is an option A, B, C, D. For example, the life insurance, like your asset insurance, many more. You need to get some information from the specialist in insurance industry, and you might need to know how much will it cost you and what the features and can benefit you as a customer itself. And nowadays, the company and the customer itself build a very close relationship, and they communicate each other, perhaps with a two-way communications. Communication at part serves to maintain the contact with an organization's existing customers and build a relationship with them. So it's not only you sell at one time, you might need a repeat purchase to your product or services. Alright, why do the marketing communication is